Is it becoming a make or break year for Daniel Jones in your mind?
Oh, clearly. I mean, the general manager talked about it in the preseason. He said this is a huge year for Daniel in terms of his development. And as a player, when you hear that from the brass and the organization, you know what time it is. And so, yeah, clearly Daniel Jones has got a lot of work to do to live up to being the sixth overall pick from three seasons ago. And we're waiting for him to graduate into that quarterback that can make the talent around him better. And let's face it, the Giants are at a point where they have to have that in terms of maintaining the brand, right? John Mara talked about it this preseason. They invested heavily in this team. He expects for this team to be competing for the playoffs, and he hears all the noise that's going on with the fan base and everybody talking. Like, the Giants are in the midst of four consecutive double-digit loss seasons, and this is the worst stretch that they've ever had in franchise history as far as that's concerned. Six out of the last seven have been double-digit loss seasons. At some point, something about that has to change. And it's not going to change unless Daniel Jones takes a huge step in terms of his development and maturation as a quarterback.
I'm glad you said that. Six out of the last seven seasons have been double-digit losses.
It's been bad, Ryan.
You never associate that with Giants in years past. So, Lewis, I got to ask, how frustrating do you think it must be for Giants owner John Mara to watch his team get pushed around at these joint practices, given all that money he has spent on making this team into, hopefully, a powerhouse?
Well, I know for a fact it is extremely frustrating because of that very fact that you just pointed out. He has invested the money. He has gone all in. He has given the organization, from the general manager on down, everything that they've asked for. They wanted to go ahead and, you know, and build this football team inside out and front to back. That's something I say constantly over and over again. They wanted to invest on the defensive and offensive lines. They wanted to get the quarterback, wanted to get the running back, build the team on the perimeter, get some more weapons. He's given them everything that they want. And if you're getting pushed around now by a rookie quarterback and by a coach who reinvested in his football team this offseason to where everyone said, oh, you can't build a team through free agency. Oh, the Patriots, oh, they're going to be another year away. Well, it doesn't look like they're a year away anymore, does it, at this point? It looks like Bill has found that magic elixir again, and John Mara is standing there watching this happen again and probably throwing his hands up in the air going, look, I know we haven't played a game yet in the regular season. A lot more work yet to be done, but what else do I need to do here in order to get us back to where the New York Giants are supposed to be, which is being a contending franchise, knocking on the door of Super Bowls? Not, are we okay? Are we in contention to win the East? Knocking on the door of Super Bowl titles is what they are accustomed to. And I think as this year plays itself out, and it's not just on Daniel Jones, if that's not where they are trending towards, he will be resetting this place once again.
Well, wow. Forget about winning the NFC East right now. How about having a season where there's not double-digit losses? That right now seems like a victory for this team. And there are a lot of things that come to mind. First of all, what would have happened if Lewis Riddick were general manager of the Giants? Just wondering out loud, just raising that question. Just saying that. Number two, I heard Chris say that Daniel Jones is the sixth overall pick. And I think that's where we run into some issues, because people think of him as the sixth overall pick. And the sixth overall pick should be a star. And I think when Daniel Jones was coming to the league, when you spoke to people around the league, they said about him that he's always going to be a good quarterback, always going to be a good quarterback. They never knew if he was going to be great. That's up to Daniel Jones to figure out if he could be great. But they always thought he'd be a good quarterback. But people equate sixth overall pick with star. And he may never be that star. He may always be a very good quarterback, and that's it. But this team, between the quarterback and the play along the rest of the roster, has to figure out a way to avoid all the losing that Chris has outlined. This is a franchise that is not used to losing that much. And they've been losers for the last 7 years, basically.
This right now, Daniel Jones' success and or failure will be, although it's on him because ultimately you're responsible for your own performance, it will also be an indictment on the entire team building operation in New York, right, if he does fail, because it's not going to be just on him. The offensive line has been mismanaged in epic proportions. To epic proportions. They had their pick of every single offensive tackle in the draft last year, and they picked Andrew Thomas, who was by far the worst one. The worst. The worst. That is on personnel. That is on coaching and development and utilization. That is something that John Mara is going to have to take a hard look at overall. It's not just Daniel Jones, but what has happened around him and That is something that is going to take a while to play itself out this year. And I will tell you this. Look, I know John Mara said he doesn't want to give them a win or else type of ultimatum this year. But he also said at the end of last year, we better be trending towards being a competitive football team because, Ryan, you've already laid it out, and, and Chris, you laid it out as well. This is a proud franchise that has won Super Bowls, man. They have multiple Hall of Famers. They play in the biggest media market in the country. You aren't supposed to be losing double-digit games over and over and over and over again and looking like you're going the wrong direction. This is a big, big, big-time year for this football team, not just Daniel Jones, but this entire football operation, and deservedly so.
Yeah, even Adam Schefter's dog is barking at you. Hear, hear. Dan Orlovsky, jump in.
Yeah, I completely agree. It's a make-or-break year for a lot of people. I'd say Daniel Jones's season comes down to 10 plays. 10 plays will determine if this season is a success for him or not. I want Daniel Jones to play as smart as he is. I mean, he's an incredibly intelligent player, but there's 10 plays a season, certainly in his first 2 years and going back to his college days, where it becomes this moment of, I call it panic, you know, where it's this, what am I going to do with the football in this moment? And for such a guy, for a guy who's so smart, he makes dumb decisions with the football in that moment. Get rid of those, and he's got a chance to build upon that. It's a make or break year for his offensive coordinator, Jason Garrett, as well. Stop playing so stagnant. Utilize him as a runner. Attack the middle of the field more and get Saquon and Kadarius Toney the ball 25 times a game. If they do that, they got a chance to be better on offense and better as a team.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.